Hello everyone, this is Nitpick Nerd, and today I want to talk about something which I mentioned in some reviews of Star Trek, about the character of Guinan, played by Whoopi Goldberg, who was a pretty good character overall. She always appeared when they had some good dialogue for her, and so as a result, whenever she did appear, she always had some very insightful, clever dialogue. I think they deliberately made her kind of mysterious character, that we know there's something more to her that we don't know about. And that was pretty interesting, but they didn't really deliver anything in the end. In the end, she was basically just a normal person who just happens to be from a species who are very long-lived, who lived for centuries, and so that can explain why she's such a wise character. And also in a few episodes they did show that she has some abilities which are surprisingly well-developed, but it makes sense if she had centuries to train them. For example, she beats a Worf in the phaser competition and stuff like that, so that was also humoristic, also funny. But if you go back early in the show, they kind of set her up to be something much more amazing and something much more than what we ended up having. For example, when she met Q in season 2, she reacted as if she has some kind of powers that might match his own, because he kind of threatened to send her away, and then she raises her hands in self-defense, and also Q looked like he's scared of her, and he said that she's not what she appears to be, she's an imp, and all kinds of stuff like that. And the very fact that she apparently was able, presumably, to defend herself from his powers implies that maybe she had some kind of powers which she simply wasn't using, that might be on the same level as Q's powers, and so that is very interesting. We can explain that away by simply saying that was simply an instinctive defensive pose, that she couldn't really do anything against him, and so maybe it doesn't really mean anything, but still it seems as if they were implying something much bigger about her. And also he said that they had some dealings 2 centuries ago, and that she had a different name then, which doesn't seem to fit the fact that she was called Guinan in the 19th century. So why did she had a different name 2 centuries ago? Why did he call her an imp? Why did he said this woman is not what she appears to be and that she's so dangerous and so on? So none of that was ever explained. I think maybe that should have been done in the prequel show Enterprise. That could have been an interesting episode, and we could have seen these 2 actors again. It was only a few years after the end of TNG, so I think they both could have been on the show, and they would look approximately the same age, so it would fit well. Now it's too late to do that, I think. But I think it would have been neat to actually see that backstory, which sounded interesting. So what kind of dealings did she have with Q? Why did it look as if she has some ability to defend herself from him? Another interesting fact is that she never told anyone about the Borg, because she says in the episode Q Who, in which they met the Borg, that the Borg wiped out her whole people. And later in the movie Generations, we saw that she was with refugees from that planet, taken in by the Federation. And so how come none of them, including Guinan, never told Starfleet about the Borg? Maybe they did tell them, and maybe Starfleet classified all of that. That's a possibility. But how come she never told Picard himself? Why was Picard surprised by all of that when he met the Borg? How come he never asked her about her people? She never explained to him what happened. He had no idea about the Borg, so none of that makes much sense either. Unless Starfleet gave her orders to not tell anyone, I guess. But all of this is extremely fishy. And sometimes they alluded to her mysterious backstory. They always said that she's so old and wise and all of that. And also they implied that she met the captain before she was on the Enterprise, which she denied, even though later on it turned out that rumor was true. Even though, how would people know about that rumor if not from her? So that didn't really make sense either. And also they never revealed where Picard met her the first time from his point of view. And why were they such close friends? It was never explained in the show, and also that Picard trusted her so much, it was never explained. And then the most curious thing happened in the episode Yesterday's Enterprise, in which the timeline changed, and yet Guinan was the only one aware of that change. And that was also never really explained. There was some line by Data who speculated that maybe Guinan's people have this unique ability, that they have a perception beyond linear time. But it was purely a speculation, which was never confirmed by Guinan herself or by anyone else. And Guinan said that she doesn't know how she knows that different timeline and all of that. That it was basically just an instinct she had. It could have been tied with that idea of her having some kind of amazing secret powers that she would be able to rival Q himself. And maybe that's how she had that perception beyond linear time. But it was never discussed on screen again. And later on in the show we had the 2-parter episode Time's Arrow, in which we discovered that Guinan was actually on Earth in the 19th century and that she met Picard from the future, and that's how she met Picard the first time from her point of view. and she had to keep it secret from him, otherwise she would risk disrupting that whole time loop. And there was a scene in which she was injured and he stayed there to look after her. And this also ties with something she once said to Jordi when she told him that she's attracted to bald men because a bald man wants to care of her when she needed help. And so I'm guessing that might be a reference to what we saw later in Time's Arrow, in which it was actually Picard who saved her in the past. And later on in the future, she met and befriended him, but he didn't know that she met him in the past. And she had to keep it secret from him as not to interrupt anything in the timeline. And all of this time loop can be used to explain how she knew the timeline changed. Because remember, she met Picard from our timeline, from the final timeline. And that's the Picard she remembers. But what happened when the timeline changed? Would she still meet that original Picard? Or would he suddenly turn into a different version of Picard? So maybe her being involved in that whole time loop was the reason for why she was able to determine when the timeline changed. It's possible that Picard told her about the future when he was with her in that cave. We didn't see that full scene. There was some moments off screen in which they were together. So it's possible that maybe Picard told her stuff about the future, and it was information about the normal timeline. And so once the timeline changed, she realized that nothing matches what was told to her by Picard. And so maybe that whole time loop can explain how she was able to know that things changed. However, she also knew stuff such as Tasha is supposed to be dead and stuff like that. And I highly doubt that when Picard was with her in that cave, he would spend the time to tell her all about his life on the Enterprise and all the other characters. And he would tell her there used to be a Lieutenant Tasha Yar who was killed in the first season, and you never met her, and so she would have that information. It doesn't really make sense unless Picard wanted to change the past. Maybe he told her stuff so that she would change something, and she didn't want to do that. So I highly doubt Picard would do that, because that would be like violating the Prime Directive, the Temporal Prime Directive. And so it doesn't make sense that he ever told her about Tasha, for example. So how did she know in yesterday's Enterprise that Tasha was not supposed to be there? And so I have to conclude that that time loop is not really the reason that Guinan was able to tell that the timeline was different now. So maybe it was part of the reason, but it was not the only one. The best explanation I can think of is what we saw in the movie Generations, in which we know that Guinan was in the Nexus, which is a dimension beyond linear time, and she was pulled out of there by a transporter beam, and because of that she said that part of her was still in the Nexus, that she wasn't completely taken out, and so it's possible she still has some kind of link to that part of herself that is still in the Nexus, and because it exists beyond linear time, maybe that's what gives her this kind of ability to see beyond linear time and see alternate timelines. And maybe in conjunction with what happened with the whole time loop, in which she met Picard from the future, together with some of her presence still being in the Nexus, maybe that can explain how she was able to sense when the timeline changed. So I think the Nexus is the best way to explain her unique abilities to see beyond linear time. And I think even in the original script of Generations, I read it once, and that was mentioned specifically. She said that ever since she came back from the Nexus, she was slightly different. I don't remember the exact quote, but the script actually alluded to that. And so that idea was to explain away Guinan's unique abilities by saying that it's because of the Nexus. Even though it raises the question, why didn't Soran have this ability too? I mean, he was also beamed out from the Nexus, just like Guinan. And so why isn't a part of Soran still in the Nexus? Why wasn't he able to see alternate timelines? Eventually Picard defeated him by going back in time and killing him before he was in the Nexus. But why couldn't Soran himself also go out of the Nexus to prevent that? So it could have been a whole temporal war between all these people in the Nexus, and yet Soran was just killed. And it's like he was never in the Nexus, so why didn't he have that unique ability? So I would still say there's something unique about Guinan specifically that makes her different from all the other people who were in the Nexus, such as Picard himself, who did not seem to be changed by his experience in any significant way. So it's something specific to Guinan. So I still think there might be some connection with the whole Q thing, because she had that conflict with Q which was never explained. And so my opinion is, if I were to invent a story, for example for an Enterprise episode for the prequel set 2 centuries ago, if I had to write such an episode, I would say that maybe another member of the Q continuum gave Guinan some Q powers, maybe temporarily, and then she had that conflict with Q, and after that her powers were taken away, except maybe some ability to defend herself against other Q. We know from a Voyager episode that the Q were actually able to give what they called Q weapons to normal humans to equip them with basically the power to fight other Q beings. And so if that was the case, that means any Q could have given part of his powers to a normal person. And so maybe such a story happened with Guinan. That's what I would write if I had to invent such a story. I would say that Guinan somehow befriended another member of the Q Continuum, and he gave her the means to defend herself specifically from Q, and that's why she raises her hands in defense when Q wanted to do something to her. And maybe some of those Q powers also gave her the ability to see beyond linear time, which can explain what happened in yesterday's Enterprise. And maybe all the three of those explanations together can explain it as well. And I kind of wonder what would happen all the other times the timeline changed. Would she really be able to tell every time something changed? Because it happens numerous times across the whole Star Trek franchise. And so if she's able to see all those alternate timelines, that would kind of make her go crazy. And that's an idea I would actually kind of like to see in the Picard show. So I'm kind of wondering how she would react to all the other timelines getting created, like all the time traveling mess that all the Star Trek franchise did with all the time traveling episodes. How would Guinan react to all those other differences? Wouldn't she kind of go crazy from all of that because the timeline was changed so many times? I heard that Whoopi said she wants to do a cameo on the Picard show, so that might be a neat way to bring her into the story. And also maybe explain why she aged so rapidly. They could explain it away by showing her in a mental institute and that she went crazy from seeing all the alternate timelines. And maybe Picard pays her a visit and seeks her advice. And she could be like an oracle character, kind of telling stuff to him that would foreshadow future events and maybe help him out in some situation later on the show. And so that would actually be kind of a clever, interesting cameo if they do it that way. So that's my thoughts on this issue. Let me know what you think and we can discuss it in the comment section, and I will see you all next time. Bye bye.